What's going on, YouTube? This your boy Perfect Cell, and right about now I'm gonna do another countdown video, and this video is on my favorite character from TV and movies from all time. Now, on my backup channel, I did my least favorite, and now, of course, I gotta bring some balance on to this whole character thing with my main channel by saying my favorite characters, man. And these characters right there, like, always look up to, and I always wanted to be like. And right about now, I wanna dive into this, and with no further ado, let's get into Perfect Cell's favorite movie and TV characters of all time. Number 10, we have Coach Carter. Man, I love Coach Carter because throughout the whole movie, he believed in the boys that he was coaching, even when the whole town didn't believe in him. Like, he really thought like these kids were more than just some kids who only got going for themselves as basketball, when the whole town thought that they were, you know? He seen them as kids with a future, man. Like, he's like, man, like, I think he's like the best father I've ever seen. Well, one of the best fathers I've ever seen anyway. But anyways, and not only that, the world seen them as boys. Coach Carter seen the men, man, and that's how he perceived them as. I think my favorite part of the whole movie is when Carter, he pretty much left it, his coaching gig because he feel like, because he didn't want to support the message that the masses was trying to bring on to the education system, you know? And he was basically saying like, dang, so y'all basically saying that, you know, playing basketball is more important than education and all that. I can't support this, so I gotta go. Man, like this is one good leader, bro. And like I said, man, like, this man, he stood up for what he believed in, and he was willing to leave his job because of his belief. And that's, man, that's what being a leader is all about for the most part. You know, just taking the risk for something that you believe in the most. And all I gotta say is this, Coach Carter, you my man, and my hats go off to you. Number 9, we have Melvin Franklin from The Temptations. Now, out of all the singers from The Temptations, the most person who I liked the most, and the most that was like dedicated, like, to me, in my opinion, was Melvin. You know, I remember when David was about to get kicked out, you know, about to get removed from The Temptations, and everybody in the whole group was like, man, like, forget David, you know, David can like kiss my ass and all this other stuff. I think Eddie was like the only one who didn't think it was a good idea, but Melvin, he was like, he wasn't like all like hateful towards David and whatnot. He was basically like, we gotta do what we gotta do, man. Like he's messing up the group. Like, he's tearing the group apart, you know? Like, he really cared about the greater good for the whole band. And he really was using his head to make this executive decision, as you should. And I'm gonna be honest with you, I didn't really like all the other members of the group. Like, Otis act like he ran everything. Eddie act like he ran everything. David was just out of control. And Paul, he was alright until he started like drinking. But Melvin, in my opinion, from what I seen, like, he's like the most responsible one in the group and the most level-headed one of the group. Like, he doesn't have any differences with any other of the bandmates, and he doesn't side with anybody. Man, and I gotta tell you this, man, I kinda cried when I seen him die at the end. Because, man, I really did like this dude, man. But anyways, bro, even like he was willing to do right by the group, even if it killed him. And I guess it did kill him. But anyways, rest in peace to my boy Melvin. Number 8, we have Mr. Incredible. Man, I just gotta say this. I'm glad that The Incredibles had a sequel because I love The Incredibles cast. And I love Mr. Incredible. I swear, like, most of his issues kind of resonate with mine. Only difference is this, like, we ain't got no kids and I ain't got super strength. And I'm not trying to hide my true identity because it's a law or nothing like that. But the reason why I say some of his problems resonate with mine is because we kind of do like work crappy dead-end jobs here and there, and we're tired of being in the same rut that we've been in, you know what I'm saying? And also, we're both cool cats, but like, people don't understand us really. And well, that's just messed up. Like, we wish we could just take it back where time was simple, man. It's a simpler time. And then me and Mr. Incredible, we all want what's for the greater good of like of humanity and what have you. And then we have to carry the weight of the world on our shoulders. Man, props to Pixar for making this movie and its sequel. Number 7, we have Luffy. Yep, Luffy is one of my favorite anime characters. He set his goal to be the king of the pirates, and not to mention his crew is badass. And not to mention, he ate a fruit that gave him some superpowers that make him stretch and whatnot. Like, it doesn't get any cooler than this. Bro, let me tell you, my favorite part is when Luffy, like, he was beating up Crocodile, and then like he was hitting him so much that Crocodile went through the damn floor, because like I guess when they was fighting, they was like somewhere in the underground, and he just went up through like the concrete. I was like, yo, like, how many of y'all wish I could do that? Like, come on, man. Like man, hey man, don't sleep on One Piece, man, and definitely don't sleep on Luffy. Alright, so number 6 we have Zero. Okay, the thing that I love about Zero is this. Like, the whole world thinks that he's stupid, but he really isn't. You know, and that's how it is with me. Like, people be thinking I don't know what's going on, but I know more than what they think I know, you know? But anyways, man, I also like Zero because, bro, man, Zero, man, that boy got some dog in him. Like, shoot, he's smart and he got some dog in him. That's what I'm talking about, shoot, because, shoot, my favorite part of Zero is when he smacked Mr. Bansky and off and then ran, bro. Like, bro. And then when Caveman found after the Azers and what have you, you know, he was saying, we gotta go back to the camp. Zero was like, I ain't going back over there. And he was like, you will die. He was like, shoot, I don't give a damn what if I die. Shoot, I'd rather die than spend another day in that piss, man. What you mean? Bro. Bro, like, man, Zero was so real. Number 5, Junior Kyle. See, I like Junior Kyle because he's funny, he's creative, he's very talented, and like, a lot of people seem to overlook that aspect of Junior. And on top of that, Junior, he's the dim-witted one of the whole show. I'm just kidding, but nah, he really is the dim-witted though. But see, the thing I like the most about Junior is this. I like how he had like this character arc throughout the whole show. Like, he was kind of like this rebellious teenager who pretty much did what he wanted to do without like any consequences. Well, he still got consequences here and there. And then after a while, he turned into a responsible adult. Granted, it took for him to have a whole kid for him to like become responsible, but you gotta admit, man, Junior, like, he came a long way. True, you gotta give props to your boy Junior. Number 4, we have Prince Hakeem. See, now the cool thing about Hakeem, in my opinion, is that even though he comes from royalty, that he comes from a straight kingdom, you know, he still wants to be respected like as any other person and not have people just kiss his ass all willy-nilly just because he has some kind of like supreme in his DNA, you know what I'm saying? And even though he's pretty much on easy street in his life, you know, he wants some type of independence for his lifestyle. He still wants a challenge, you know, like he's tired of like, you know, living the easy life as a king, getting whatever he wants whenever he want to get it, you know what I'm saying? Like, for instance, at the beginning of the movie, like, Hakeem was supposed to marry like this one girl, but he was like, you know what, I'm not going to marry someone who's that submissive, who does everything that I say. Like, nah, man, I want a woman with a mind of her own. Like, what the heck, bro? You know what I'm saying? Like, he was like, damn, like, shoot, I want to pick my queen. I don't want my queen to be picked out for me. And I also like how generous he was, too, when he gave, like, that whole stack of money to the homeless. I like that. But anyways, yeah, man, like, do your thing, Prince Hakeem. Like, I can't wait till they come out with a Coming to America, too. I heard that's on the way, man. Number 3, Alex Hitchens. Now, I gotta say this, bro. Hitch, man, Hitch, he's the type of cat that I'm trying to be right now. Charismatic, smooth, intelligent, and he moves freely and independently. Man, Hitch got it going on, man. Like, I'm trying to get like him, bro. But anyways, my favorite part of the movie is when, like, his cover was pretty much blown thanks to these dumb thoughts and all this other stuff, man. Always crying about, like, the love doctor, like, and crap like that. But he was basically saying that, like, listen, like, I wasn't trying to like get these people laid. I was trying to create opportunities. Like I'm trying to like get, you know, he was looking out for the little guy, basically. You know, he was looking out for the little guys with potential to make them become the big men with potential and have a chance with the woman of their dreams, you know? But yeah, man. Like I said, man, Hitch, man, that's my guy right there. Number two, we have Cell from Dragon Ball Z. Come on now, look at me. You know I had to be put Cell high on this list. You knew I had to put him on this list at all anyway. Shoot, like, now I wasn't gonna be predictable and put him at number one, but man, I love Cell. Can't y'all tell? Like, that's my favorite Dragon Ball Z villain of all time, and shoot, to be honest, that's my favorite villain that I've, like, ever. Like, don't get me wrong, Majin Buu, Frieza, like, they were cool and all, but Cell was pretty much every fighter up to that point, bro. Every fighter up to that point, all rolling to one android. Now, that's what you call the ultimate android. Man, and I can't wait for his resurrection to come, man, because I think they might do a resurrection with him. I'm not sure, but if they do, I'm watching that joint front and center. Because it could be possible that if they make a resurrection and have it be part of the canon, it might be some of the, he might have some hell of a bit of abilities, man. Like, not only he'll possess the abilities that he already possessed in his own arc back in Dragon Ball Z, but he'll probably be able to possess some abilities from Beerus and Whis and all this other stuff, man. I can't wait to see this. And then another thing about Cell, you know, like how when people do after image and multiply and like it kind of like divides their power level. Well, with Cell, like, shoot, when he like put the Cell Juniors up, it didn't divide his power level at all. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, man, I love Cell, and shoot, I love Cell so much, I named myself after him. And that tells you a lot. But anyways, now let's unveil the number one pick. Number one, Carl Winslow. Yes, the patriarch of Family Matters is number one on this list. See, the thing about Carl Winslow, he's hard and he's fair. And then he's funny, he's generous, and he's modest. And sometimes he can't be modest, man. And also, Carl Winslow, man, like, he's a really good father. And, like, people don't really see how much of a good father he is. Now, I get it. You know, people love Uncle Phil, and I respect Uncle Phil, but I think Carl Winslow is as great of a father as Uncle Phil, if not a better father, you know? Because even when he doesn't really have much, he still makes a way for, like, people to, like, be helped and what have you. Like, he still, like, helps people. Like, I remember one Christmas episode where Carl Winslow, he was Santa Claus, and the kid, he came up to him and was like, hey, I need a job for my dad. And then he was like, all right, I'm gonna hook him up with a job. And let's not forget that Carl, he took in Steve Urkel to live with him. Mind you, Steve Urkel is a pain in the ass to Carl Winslow and a pain in the ass to the whole family, but he still let him live with him. Like, that's, man, if that ain't love, I don't know what is, man. And because he took him in, like, he knows that Steve isn't a bad person. He might be annoying, but, like, you know, he's a good kid and he deserves to, like, to stay in Chicago where he belongs. And not to mention, shortly after he took in Steve, he took in an orphan and he gave him and he gave him like a change of lifestyle. Like, he went from to being an inner kid to the city of Chicago and to potentially becoming into something successful. Like, I don't care what nobody say, Carl Winslow in my eyes is the father of the year. But anyways, guys, this concludes this video. You know, let me know who are your favorite movie and TV characters. Let me know in the comment section what you think about this list. And like always, this is Perfect Cell, and I'm Ghost.
Sweet Mary J, Mary Kate, and Ashley, two twins rolled up, I think it was a Saturday.